I normally sit in the cop, but it was only the Bradford end that was open. So I came in there, tried to use the excuse to get on the side of the pitch that I wanted to go to the toilet, which is in the stand. But the steward, I thought it was going to usher me into the stand, but I saw a little bit of smoke and jokingly said, you know, I'm not going in there, there's a fire, just so I could sneak along the pitch. And I couldn't believe it, but he just allowed me to not go in and to, you know, go off on my way. And I got about halfway there and it just went up. And everyone was spilling out onto the pitch, so I just moved back a little bit, and it wasn't long before I saw a little boy crying, and I just scooped him up, and I thought he was crying because he'd lost his daddy, but actually he'd lost his trainer and his mum had just bought it. So it was really upset about that. So I just said, your mum won't be bothered, she'll be just so happy to see you, you know, she won't be bothered about your trainer, don't worry about that. And I was just hoping that his family would turn up, so we were just basically stood. I was just guarding him a little bit so that he couldn't see various things that were going on around us. And they emptied the ground about, I don't know what time it'll have been, but it might have been about 5-ish, 5:15. We were probably about the last to leave. I just kept hanging back, hoping that his family would be doing the same, but they just said we had to go, so we headed out. I did mention that the little boy wasn't mine and I was trying to, but they obviously had other things that they needed to deal with at that time. So we got down, we started walking down Midland Road, and that's when I realised how bad it was, because the firefighters were recovering and getting some attention, and there were an oxygen, and it was, I realised then just how, you know, it was far worse than I first thought. But we got to the car park and the car was still there, which still made me feel, because I thought, well, the ground's empty and his car's still here. I don't know what time it was, maybe 6:15, 6:10. A group of men just appeared on the horizon of Midland Road coming down, and they all had their heads bowed, and my heart was racing, and Johnny just went, "Danny!" And it was just like a miracle, honestly. All their heads went up, they just ran down the hill and just grabbed me. It was so lovely.
Yeah, not much recollection of a fire on the day. I've often wondered who the person that helped me was over the years, especially when my son got to a similar age as I was on the day. Yeah, just made me think, you know, what a good thing this lady had done, and that I would really like to thank her one day, but would I ever, you know?
Well, like, crikey, now I've been a parent, now I am a parent. At the time I was only 21, didn't have children, so once you have your own children you realise just how awful it is when you just lose them for a couple of minutes, but for an hour and a half in a situation like that.
Yeah, all I can relate it to is, you know, losing one of my kids for 10 seconds in a supermarket, and you know, your heart dropping out, and where are they, and then the relief. But for it to have been such a traumatic event in the stadium, and for my dad to have lost us for so long, and my mum's, you know, what she must have been going through as well back at home, because one of the neighbours had told her what was going on at the ground. I can't really imagine how they were feeling at the time.
Because it's such a nice story, and it was the anniversary, just thought, oh, put that story on, because it's a nice, you know, it's just something a little bit different. And I wonder where you all are. But I guess it wasn't put on as a, like a search, you know, it was just to share that story because it's so nice and it's stayed with me for a long time.
Yeah, it was a phone call actually from my wife that alerted me to the message. I was doing some gardening at home. She'd been sat in the car just waiting to pick the children up from school, and she was just reading through some posts, and a mutual friend of ours had shared Karen's story, and she was thinking, oh, what a lovely story that is. And then she was like, oh, that's Johnny, you know. And I got a phone call from her in a bit of excitement to say that the lady shared your story, and she tagged me in the post, so I could see it straight away, and yeah, sort of commented as search over it was me, and got in touch with a personal message.
I was just stunned. I couldn't believe it. Yeah. And I guess that he'd always, when he said that he'd, you know, wanted to find me, that had never occurred to me, to be honest. It never occurred to me. Obviously, I knew his parents would have.
I just wanted to say thank you. So we made sure that we met, you know, really quickly. I think the message, I received it on the Friday, and by the Sunday we'd met up and said thank you to Karen for, you know, just for what she did on the day. But like, just wanted to hear her story, her side of things. And my mum said she really can't wait to thank her for what she did on the day. Yeah. And we are planning to meet up shortly.
I want to meet his family. He's got his own family now, which is just lovely, isn't it? And his parents too, because I'm sure they'll have their own story around that. Mum being at home, not knowing, you know, dad, you know, not knowing, and then it all